name is Nicole, and today I will introduce to you the Crenova A3 13-inch laminator. I bought this laminator off of Amazon Prime. I got it at a lightning deal for $39.09, but I think it's listed now at $45.99. So this is Crenova Dual Mold A3 laminator. It laminates hot and cold laminating pouches. It supports 3 to 5 millimeter pouches. It's ready in 2 minutes. It has LED indication lights, a hot and cold system, and an ABS jam release button to release paper jams. Inside the box, you receive your Crenova laminator, an instruction manual, a card that says satisfied, frustrated, a paper trimmer, a paper cutter, and 20 pouches of various sizes. This is the A3 size, the largest size that the laminator can handle. It also comes with 10 A6s. I've used these already. This is my last laminating sheet. It comes with 6 A6s, 5 A5s, 5 A4s, 5 A3s, the largest. Hopefully this will give you an idea of what sizes you can use these sheets for. I am putting together a toddler folder for my daughter that I downloaded off of JDA's YouTube channel. Well, she has a website. I follow JDA's YouTube channel, and I decided to put this toddler learning folder together for my daughter. And I had previously printed out a few of the pages and tested it. She loves it. I love it. It's quick and easy to go over her ABCs and numbers and colors and shapes. And I'm so happy to have this laminating machine, because now I don't have to worry about these getting torn. So, I have laminated all of the small pieces. What I've discovered is that, of course, this is my first laminator. I've never laminated before. I'm happy about how quick and easy and simple it is to use. However, when I had these, what I had in mind to laminate, like the letter size, 8.5 by 11 inches, I was thinking that I would be able to laminate more of the letter size pages using the A4. However, this is A4. As you can see, this has not been laminated. There is no additional room to use this size. So, instead of using the A4, now I did use this one, an A4, but I ended up trimming the top to make it fit into this pouch, a regular letter size paper. And what I did for the rest of the papers, I used the larger A3 size, like this. I put one on the front and one on the back and laminated it, which turned out just fine. I'm gonna just cut it out, and you see, once I cut it out, it's just fine. I used a paper trimmer and a paper cutter, and it turned out just fine. Oh goodness, is this still recording? Did this just shut off on me? I'm gonna just pick up where I left off. And actually, I can't tell. I think it's recording. Is that button? Let me see. I don't know how to tell if this is recording or not. We'll see. I'm gonna do this again. So it came out just fine using a larger size. But if I was just laminating some documents and thinking that I could put two sheets of paper here, I mean, I don't know what I would have done with this space if I wasn't able to put two sheets of paper here. So I was a little disappointed with that, but it worked out fine because I'm, you know, putting the folder together. So I had all of these little pieces of paper, so it worked perfectly for me, actually. But just to let you know, if you were expecting what to expect, let me get your laminating pouches. Now, I still have to figure out what size laminating pouches and what to get for this to suit my needs, so I will be looking it up, and maybe I'll link what I've decided to get. Alright, so on to the demonstration. Now, I have started laminating some of her sheets, but I have not finished. I was just too anxious to try it out. So I'm gonna move these things out of the way. And we'll show you how it works. It's very quick, it's very simple. I like how easy it is to use. It's lightweight, so when I'm done with it, I can just store it and put it away. Move this box over here. Alright, so I have this right here. I have a laminator. I still need to plug it in, so excuse me. 1 second. I plug this in. Okay. 1 second. So, first up, plug it in. And, let me go over it with you, because I talked about what came in the box, but did not discuss the actual laminator. So you have the Crenova laminator right here. You'll see the indicator lights, ready, power. This is the inlet. This is the outlet on this back side. On the left side, on my left side, we have the on, off switch, and the hot and cold button. So right now it's off. You turn it here. It's hot, here is cold. On the back, you have the ABS release lever. You just push this to release paper. It just jammed up. And on the top here, you'll see some symbols. Now, the instruction manual didn't have anything in there about the symbols, but I imagine this means caution. That it is hot. This says max entry width is 8.3 for the paper size. The maximum lamination thickness is 0.5 millimeters. The laminating pouches should be 80 to 125 microns. And of course, don't use paper clips in your laminating machine if you want to keep it. So that's it. Simple design, it's light, you just plug it in and turn it on. So that is what I'm going to do. We are going to laminate. I'm going to just do one sample. I'm going to laminate a few numbers and letters and planets for today. So I'm going to turn this on to hot. It takes 2 minutes. Heat up, so it'll flash green, and when it's ready, the green light will remain solid. It will not flash anymore. Okay, because I have this recording and I'm still new to this camera. So we'll just sit here. There is a smell, a slight smell. And then you turn it on and it's heating up. Which maybe we should go ahead and because it's very distinct. Okay, so your laminating sheets are already a little rounded, it has rounded corners. And I should probably show you how to load it up because I've never used a laminating, but this is what you can expect. They come with these pouches, and you pretty much just open it up, slide your pieces of paper in, and arrange it. I read, just looking up how to use a laminating machine, that you should leave at least a fourth of an inch in between your pieces of paper just to make sure you have a good seal. Of course, I did not do that with all of these because I'm trying to fit as much as I can. And so far, it's turned out pretty well. As you can see, these aren't very close together. Let's see if I have some that's close together. And I haven't started to cut these out yet. These are pretty much spaced out very okay. But I was, you know, like right here is pretty close together, but there's a seal. I can tell that it's sealed all the way through. Oh, this camera shut off on me again. I don't know if it's recording. Alright, you can see that it is ready. And I am turning on this camera again. I don't think I'm recording. Or else it would not be. Do I need to hold it down to record? I think I'm supposed to be looking for the red light here, not here. I think that's the power button. I'm gonna hold it down. I did it, but it's not really doing anything. Alright, well, this is just a practice run. Here you go. So, here is our laminator. It's warm, of course, it's very hot right there. You don't want to touch it. But, I mean, you won't burn yourself. Make sure you have plenty of space on both sides. There's something dirt under here. I'm trying to get that out. Of course, it wants to stick to the paper. I only did that when I opened up the flap. Alright, so I'll just slide this sealed in first, right in the middle. There are like little guide marks here, but I don't think it has to be like on the edge. You just want it as straight as you can and you slide it in until it catches and let it do its thing. First time I did this, I kind of wasn't paying attention to shift it, and so glad I had time to shift it back into place. I kind of like to just hold it up, but it's not necessary. And then you'll see it come through on the other side. Thank you. smooth. I think there's a little bubble right there. That's the first bubble I've noticed so far. Laminated half my sheets last night. And you can take a look. If you can tell, I'm gonna set it down here. Now I'm gonna shut this off. I read that if you have a dual mode laminator, that you should switch it over to cold, just to preserve it. It'll make it last longer. I don't know how true that is, but that is what I am going to do. And just allow it to cool off. And that's it. You pretty much plug it in, slide your, insert your pieces of paper, let it do its job, and turn it off. Done. It's that quick and simple to use. And that's it. So, we have this. I am going to demonstrate the little paper trimmer. I've never used one of these before until yesterday. I'm going to try to cut this right in the middle. And just slide this through. May have to lift the ruler up. If you can see, this is the paper trimmer. It slides across. And do it back and down. It kind of catches on the end, so I don't know if that's a safety thing or I'm just holding it funny. And it just slides across. And it's also hard to tell exactly where it cuts. I had a hard time trimming that one sheet of paper. But it's basically used for laminating sheets, so it's clear, so you'd be able to see it better if you're cutting laminating strips. And you use your ruler for your guide. Of course, this is not really straight, so I'm not quite sure exactly where it's going to cut, but let's give it a try. And hold your paper down. And slide it up a little bit more. Don't want it too close. And just slide it through. And in the instruction manual, it says if you cut up to 3 pieces of paper, voila. Right in the middle. Of course, I don't have these pieces in straight, but. And you see, I have this. It left a little corner. So we're going to take a little paper rounder here and cut the corners. Now I find this a little bit funny. You have to press it just right to cut it cleanly. And you just slide it through. And I did not press it just right. Kind of just bent it. And so I think I just have to play with it. But that's how I got it. Hello.
You recording?
I am, but I don't think see clean. So it's just how I press it. Although that I don't think I ever started recording. You gotta have to show me how to record on that.
Yeah.
I
was going to tell you, you know, you can do more than you know, once session.
That is it. Well, this is my first one. So you can see, it's rounded.
You got to use the camera and stuff.
Right here. It works out pretty well. So that was the demonstration of the Crenova A3 laminator. The paper cutter, trimmer,